Hello, my name is Alan Chandler, and I am here to do a reading for the Good Friday service at the request of Reverend Taylor and Deacon George. The verse that I'm going to cover is actually the first one It covers the first words that Christ said while he was right after he was nailed to the cross during his crucifixion on Good Friday. Because it's chapter 23, verse 34 from Book of Luke, and it's very short. Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. They divided his garments by casting lots. And I'm going to focus on the forgiveness aspect of his statements there. Because when I hear that, my assumption is that, or belief is that Jesus had already forgiven his executioners and detractors himself. And he was also requesting that his Father, our Lord, to also offer forgiveness to the same parties. When I look at forgiveness, I think it's an extension. I mean, it was another extension of his life's teachings in terms of offering always love and forgiveness. And there are numerous stories of forgiveness in the Bible by Jesus. And I think our Lord's Prayer that we basically do every Sunday during service with forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. It's really an extension of that, but where that is asking forgiveness for ourselves. He's requesting forgiveness for people he has already forgiven himself. I think forgiveness is an important aspect of our lives, or should be. Not so sure I'm that good, or whether some days I'm not certain whether I've really asked for forgiveness or granted forgiveness, probably is more the case of to others that I potentially could have at different times of my life. Because, if you really can't, if you can't grant someone forgiveness, you really find yourself in struggles in terms of anguish and bad feelings and things, in terms of if someone is you're close to has done something to harm you or disappointed you. Forgiveness is really something we should be able to, or we should try to achieve by going to the person and asking and telling them, "We forgive you." I'm not certain I really have ever done that, but I think it's something I would have been better off at certain times to do that and to be able to, get over something more quickly and try to mend and build trust in relationships again. Because it always amazes me that, when you hear stories of people saying they forgive people who've done horrendous crimes. I know the church there in Charleston was with Dylann Roof was the per young man that killed a number of people in a church service one evening. And not very long after that, I know the pastor and a number of other people got up and said they forgave him. And that, and I'm not sure in those circumstances I'm really that capable of doing that, but it's something I think we should potentially think about trying to strive. And I will state that I've read a number of things of Billy Graham on forgiveness and things over the last couple of years, because I know there was an episode that really struck me on The Crown season 2, I think it's episode 6, but that's where Queen Elizabeth first met Billy Graham, and they actually became relatively somewhat close in terms of providing guidance. And she had cause to think that she should grant forgiveness to her uncle, who was been the former king before he abdicated, and she just could not do it. But there's a good discussion on those aspects. Hopefully we can make some changes and study Christ's word. Thank you. Good evening.